All right, we've got a president apparently trying to force out his attorney general. We have a former campaign chair receiving a subpoena to go testify before the Senate Judiciary Committee. A lot going on. Back now with our panel. Margaret Hoover, first to you. We just spoke to Congressman Ken Buck of Colorado, your home state. He would not address directly the fact that the president, according to his own communications director, would like the attorney general out. You know, he essentially said the attorney general is doing a good job, but he wouldn't criticize the manner with which the president's doing on it. You had a strong reaction to that.
Look, I mean, I know Ken Buck because he's from my home state. He's a good friend. We know his family. He does not like the behavior of this president. Let me just tell you, it is totally counter to Ken Buck and how he comports himself in public office and to how many, many Republicans view the office of the presidency and what should come from the president's lips. What you saw there was a very reluctant member of Congress, reluctant to criticize the president. And this is what you have. Donald Trump won his district by 23 points. All right. And so this is the dynamic you have in Congress, is you have many, many members of Congress whose seats really depend on the success of, frankly, the actions over the next week. Is health care repealed and replaced or not? And many of them who could lose their seats if Donald Trump isn't successful. Mm-hmm. And so while this absolutely undermines their idea of what the presidency should be and how the president should comport himself, they are quite reluctant to criticize him because it frankly risks their future in office and their future majority.
Which, Mark Preston, gives the president's license to do this again and again and again, no?
It certainly does. I mean, look, in the many tweets that he has sent out today, one of them was, I'm going to Ohio. We expect big crowds to come out here tonight. You know, it's okay, I think, as president or as a politician to think in political terms to try to get things done. What's not okay, though, is how you go about doing it. And then you try to turn the blame on others when you're not able to get things done. So, for instance, on health care, we saw President Trump last night turn to his HHS secretary, Tom Price, and say, you better get the votes, Tom. You better get the votes. Well, I don't know anyone else on this panel, but I've never known an HHS secretary who's been able to go and whip votes. That lays strictly at the doorstep of the president of the United States. And that's something that we haven't seen President Trump focused on. Today, he could have been focused on trying to get to 51 votes. Instead, he has decided to go off and attack his attorney general.
You know, Asha, we know that if you're special counsel Bob Mueller, obviously you're probably curious about what this might mean for your job. Not that Bob Mueller needs a job. I mean, I'm not sure that he really cares whether he's fired or not. No. That's an aside there. But what do you make of it if you are the special counsel right now? All these tweets, these personal statements coming from the president of the United States, do they factor into your investigation?
I think to some extent they will, in the sense that you're going to hunker down and make sure that you get as much covered as you can. I think the president fails to understand the nature of the legal system and a bureaucracy. Even if Mueller goes away, the investigation is not going to disappear into thin air. That is just not how our criminal justice system works. The premise of these investigations was begun a year ago. They will continue in the FBI. I've been in the FBI. I know this. They simply cannot just close this midstream. So he's going to, I think, take into account that it's possible he may leave, and to make sure that there are mechanisms in place for this investigation to continue. And I think that the president, if that's his goal, to shut down the investigation down, he will be sorely disappointed, because it will go on and it will be completed.
Mark Preston, all of this has been happening this morning. It's pretty hard, frankly, to keep up. But Paul Manafort being subpoenaed to appear in public tomorrow, as Asha pointed out earlier, if he doesn't, he could be held in contempt of Congress. What's your playbook for Paul Manafort? Does he come? Does he plead the fifth? What does he do?
Well, clearly he has some concern about going before the Senate Judiciary Committee. Now, we do know that he's going to go to the Senate Intelligence Committee, or we're told anyway that he will do that. I think what Paul Manafort has done, though, is that he's drawn a line in the sand, so to speak. And I think from that line, he will now try to negotiate with Congress to see what he can get out of Congress in terms of protection, if there is need to be protected. But as the subpoena is being issued, or at least as we're told, because it was issued late last night, but as we're told today, we have Jared Kushner, the son-in-law of the president going up to Capitol Hill on day two, and right now is behind closed doors testifying as well. So talk about a distraction right now. This whole Russia investigation has been on the Trump presidency.
Hey, Margaret, can I ask you a question about health care? Because that is, you know, behind door number three. As
huge
it were today.
Deal today,
you know, a vote that will be historic one way or the other. The Senate looks like it will vote on the motion to proceed. You know, I suppose it could kill conclusively the effort right now for health care, or it could open the door for more votes next week. What pressure do you think being felt by the Republican members of the Senate right now?
Well, I think they're under an enormous amount of pressure to a certain extent, but I mean, this is why Paul Ryan had his press conference, right? I mean, what Paul Ryan said is, I have an agenda. But what he was really saying, without saying it, is, we did our job, guys. It's your time now. I mean, that's why Paul Ryan got there and had a press conference right now, because he really didn't have much substantively to say that was new, right? But I think part of it is because the president hasn't been all in, hand-wringing, 100% trying to twist the arms of Shelley Moore Capito and Rob Portman and all of these moderate Republicans.
Not at all with some of them.
What you have is Mitch McConnell looking at the map for 2018 for the Senate re-election bid and seeing a really easy map compared to the Democrats. I mean, the chance that the Republicans continue to have a majority control of the Senate in 2018 is very, very high, regardless of whether they vote on health care or not. The real problem is the House of Representatives, and that's why Paul Ryan was up there today.
All right, guys, thank you so much. Margaret Hoover, Mark Preston, Asha Rangappa. Quite a bit of news to get through today. We appreciate you rocking and rolling with us.
Yeah.